Welcome to Pyramid Times. Myself, Veena Sukhu, VP at Pyramid Times, and we have with us an amazing guest, Dr. Hari Prasad. Dr. Hari Prasad is a pediatric surgeon at Anantapur, Andhra Pradesh, India, and he is also a heartfulness meditation trainer, spreading this beautiful technique and wisdom to one and all. He also has an ABBA TV YouTube channel, which is very hilarious, through which he will get everybody to the present moment and see the beauty of this our own lives. With this, I welcome Dr. Hari Prasad, sir, to Pyramid Times. Welcome, sir.
Yeah, good evening to all. Thank you, Sister Veena, for admiring me and encouraging me to continue this type of classes. And I am basically a pediatric surgeon. I am settled in Anantapur. My studies went through MBBS in Tirupati, Karnool MS, and in Nilofar, I did my pediatric surgery. And now I am settled in Anantapur. I have started my own hospital, and I am consulted in almost 9 hospitals. Yeah. Meanwhile, I am meditating. I am doing meditation for past 20 years almost. So I am doing meditation for past 20 years. There are so many reasons to start meditation in the early age of life. Basically, I don't like meditation at the time. I was not liking meditation at the time. But when I was doing MBBS, I got so many doubts. Everybody teaching me about my physical body. Nobody is teaching about me. That means myself. Where am I going? How I am entering into the system? That's what no one could answer me when I was studying MBBS. After that, so many struggles in life that made me to think about why this struggle persistently in life. Because on the day of death, we are not carrying anything with our hands. So why this struggle? Why should I continue with this struggle? Is there any link with this earthly journey, with my cosmic journey, or else any link is like that? Any link present like that or not? I thought of. So I started meditation in 2002 in Sri Ramachandra Mission. Now it is called as Heartfulness Meditation. In Ramachandra Mission, the first sitting itself was very much profound, very much profound. And that cosmic energy they have given through that meditation session brought my consciousness level from the physical to the deeper course. My body was almost completely relaxed, and I have gone something beyond my physical body within 10 minutes of meditation. I was surprised how this has happened. How can I forget my physical body? That's what I was amazed on that day. Then I started doing meditation very vigorously out of my busy schedule. For past 18 years, I am doing my surgical practice in Anantapur district. But every moment, there was a very, very busy practice in surgery. After that, pediatric surgery. Now I am the only one super specialty surgeon for children in whole Anantapur district. So likewise, it is going on continuously. But I find time to meditate. Every day I used to meditate around 2 to 3 hours minimum. If not possible, 2 to 3 hours. If possible, it will be around 3 to 4 hours or 5 to 6 hours. I like to spend in meditation. So meditation, it is not like money earning. If you earn money, you can show so many things to the society with a luxury car, a luxury villa, and so many properties, income tax, bank accounts. Likewise, so many things you can show with money earning. But with meditation, you cannot show anything to anyone. It is purely subjective. Out of my 18 years of my experience, I cannot show anything to you. But I understood the physiology, philosophy, and the science behind the soul, behind the Paramatma, behind the God, behind the infinity. And from the infinity, how this earthly journey of a human being is linked, and time journey, those things I could correlate, I could realize to little extent. That's what happening. So, what is meditation? We'll start with ABCDs of heartfulness meditation. So what is meditation? What are the other methods of meditation? So many types of meditations are there. Almost 1300 types of meditations are there. First of all, what is meditation? Meditation means practicing the focusing of mind. Practicing the focusing of mind, not focusing the mind. It is practicing. We are meditating means we are practicing still. So what is that practice? How we have to practice meditation? Yeah. So that's how. So what is meditation? It is a practicing focusing of mind. So how to practice it? Is it possible with ourselves, or guru is needed? A master is needed to guide us in the path of spiritual journey. Definitely we need a guru who can help us, who has mastered himself to guide us through the meditation. So in meditation, we'll stick onto a single suggestion. We are not forcing mind onto the, so divine light present in my heart. This is a single suggestion. It is single idea, just an idea. We are not thinking that divine light present in my heart. We are not forcing the mind to focus on it. We are not forcing. We are just thinking that divine light present in my heart. Just thinking. So after 2 to 3 seconds, after 2 to 3 minutes, it will go away from our original idea, and mind will intrude so many thoughts. Almost a human mind can intrude 70,000 thoughts per day. Out of them, we'll focus on 200 to 100. Out of them, we'll work upon 10 to 20. Out of them, we have to work only with one idea, one thought. But disturbance is there with 69,999 thoughts. That is how mind power is. Such a powerful and such a subtle and most powerful mind that has existed. So such a mind power, if you want to get control, first you have to be peaceful, restful. You should not force it. You should not apply power. You should not apply willpower. Just relaxed and subtle suggestion. Divine light present in my heart. Dosa, idli, puri, vada, upma. Everything comes. Heroines comes. Heroes comes. So many divine deities comes. So many worldly things comes into our mind. So of them, we'll be hanging to something, and we'll be hanging to some other thinking process. And we are skipping from the basic idea of divine light present in my heart. We are going through that thought process. Again, remind, divine light present in my heart. I am sticking onto that. Just remind it. Again, after 2 to 3 minutes, again, you will be going away. Likewise, this mind never stops, including even in sleep also, it will be working through dreams. Even in the deepest sleep, it is absorbing the deepest core of essence, our soul essence, our Paramatma essence. It will absorb, it is absorbing. That's how mind continuously works with us. That's why you have to practice to gain control over it. You have to practice. That practice may take months to years. Some persons it takes decades. Some persons it takes janmas also. So that much difficult power, if you have practice, that will be a best tool in your hand. It reveals everything. In heartfulness meditation, there is a process called yogic transmission, pranahuti shakti. It is emanating from the guru. So from that guru, it is coming and it is connecting through our heart, and it is purifying our heart. It is purifying our system. It is clearing all the disturbances. It is clearing all the disturbances. It is clearing all the nuisances. It is clearing everything from our system. That's how slowly that transmission, if you let it work upon it, slowly it will show its effect. So in heartfulness meditation, we will practice to let it work upon us first. After that, we will work with the transmission to work upon others. So that is how you need a practice. You need a practice. The first day itself, nobody is a saint. The first day itself, nobody is a great personality. The first day itself, nobody is going to be a hero. It takes practice. It takes time. That is how this heartfulness meditation works with the help of yogic transmission. So I can say so many things about heartfulness meditation, but it is of no use. You have to experience it. You have to experience it. If you experience only, then you can trust it. You can analyze it. You can get a command over that experience. Then only you can understand the basic things in the Sahaj Marg. So in this, there are three steps are there. One is relaxation guided meditation. Second is cleaning process. Third is connecting with the heart. These three steps are there. So for that, we need three consecutive days for meditation connection. So first day, we are going, today itself, I am going to give you relaxation guided meditation. Second day, tomorrow, I will be giving cleaning session. Day after tomorrow, I will be giving connecting with the heart. So the cleaning, today, in relaxation guided meditation, I will give audio suggestions. So all of you, just close your eyes and gently follow whatever I say and observe what is happening in you. Just observe. Don't try to do anything. Just observe. So what are the benefits of this heartfulness meditation? What are the benefits of meditation at all? Why we need meditation? So nowadays, education becoming totally materialized. Totally material education. So if I study IAS, if I study MBBS, after MBBS I can practice and I can earn this much. If I become a collector, I'll be ruling this one, this much salary I'm going to get, this much reputation, this much show off I can get. If IPS, this much show off, this much power. Everything calculated in the means of materialism. We are losing our own identity in the process of material education. What we are actually. At the time of birth, I am not an IAS officer. At the time of birth, I am not a doctor. After the education process, I became a doctor. After the education process, some people will become engineers, some people will become officers. Somehow education will transform them. If those failed, they will be settling in their own professions. And in that professions, they are shining. Sometimes they are losing. If they shine, society will treat them as heroes. If they lose, society treat them as a loser. That loser, he himself compares with this world unnecessarily. And he will lose his inner peace. That is how this material education and material basis is disturbing our purity, disturbing our mindsets totally. So with the heartfulness meditation, you are always connected with the reality of the heart. And this heart is the center of the chakra, which is connecting both material worlds and inner spiritual worlds. There are so many worlds inside of you. If you go through your heart, the next chakra you are going to get is Atma chakra, after that Agni chakra, Bhumi chakra, Vayu chakra, after that 6th point, 7th point, 13th point. Till 13th point you will make a journey and you will realize so many worlds, so many areas within you which are not revealed to you in all these years, all these janmas, that will be revealed. That is how this heartfulness meditation helps. And also you are getting a peace which is deeper and deeper peace. And finally you are settling in absolute infinity, which is totally nothingness, paramashunya sthiti. In such a state, if you are settled, nothing in this world, nothing in this creation can disturb you. You are accepting everything as a gift of God. You are accepting everything as your purpose of journey. That is how this heartfulness meditation helps. And also it improves focusing. I want to remove the word concentration. You cannot concentrate the mind. You can focus. So improved focus ability, improved learning, improved creativity, improved peace, and very much better health and hormonal balances and restful attitude and perfection in what you are doing. And all these things can happen with the continuous practice of heartfulness meditation. Even today also, my master is still practicing. He says, I am not a master, I am still practicing. That's how practice only keeps everyone perfect in this creation. So practice should never stop. Practice should continue for infinite time. That is how this heartfulness meditation can impact your education, impact your career, impact your creativity. Everything can be impacted with the heartfulness meditation. and you will becoming excel in your profession. That is how it happens. And moreover, today itself, I cannot tell anyway so many things about heartfulness, but it is boring and it will be annoying. So if you are, all of you are ready, I'll give you a relaxation technique if you are ready. Okay. If you are sitting in a chair, please relax comfortably and rest your back on your chair. Okay. First, you will taste the sweet. You will taste the essence. Then we'll discuss. Okay. Right. All of you, please sit back. Relax in your chairs. Close your eyes. Gently close your eyes. No pressure on eyelids, please. Very much relaxed attitude should be there in your body, and you can give a suggestion that your body is relaxing totally. Now bring your attention into your heart, inside, and gently bring that attention onto your toes. From the toes, gently shake your toes, and now the relaxation energy is entering into your system from the earth. From the earth, a relaxation energy is entering into your feet, and slowly that energy is relaxing your toes, your feet, your feet are becoming so free. Slowly, that energy is passing into your ankles. Your ankles are getting relaxed and becoming so free. And slowly, that energy is entering into your legs, under your knees, under your thighs. All the leg muscles are getting relaxed. Your knees are becoming so relaxed. Your thigh muscles are completely relaxing with that energy. Your legs are becoming so free and relaxed, very much loose. Gently, that energy is entering into your pelvis. All your pelvic muscles are getting relaxed. Your pelvis is becoming so free. Slowly, that energy is entering into your spinal cord. Your total spine is getting relaxed with that energy, and it is becoming so loose and so free. Now, energy is entering into your abdomen, and into your chest. Your abdomen and all muscles, all organs are becoming relaxed and becoming tension-free and totally relaxed. Now, energy is entering into your chest, and your chest muscles are getting relaxed. All your tension in the chest is getting removed, and you're becoming so peaceful and happy. Now, energy is entering into your shoulders. From there, it is traveling up to your fingers. All your arm and forearm muscles are getting relaxed. Energy is entering into your neck from the chest. Your neck muscles are getting relaxed. Now the energy is entering into your head, removing all the tension in your head. Now, your total body from the head to toe, toe to head, that relaxation energy is passing very smoothly and removing the whole tension in your body. Now gently bring your attention into your heart. A divine light from your heart is glowing and drawing your attention. You are drowning in that relaxation and peace of the divine light, and you are getting slowly absorbed into that. Now, gently open your eyes. Observe, how was your system and how is your system before relaxation and after relaxation? How is the condition? Please try to observe.
Okay.
Yeah. So it was started with relaxation. Now, and finally it is diverted into your heart, inside of your system. And you observe, so many people observe that they are feeling and peaceful and relaxed. So many people observe, that's a good observation. So the power of observation, my guru, Dr. Kamlesh Patel, will emphasize more on observation. Whenever you observe, you will find something in that, and you can find a way to change the course of that. Anything, it is inside or outside, it doesn't matter. Observe first. So nowadays, each and every individual attitude is not up to the mark, according to, not up to the mark and not according to the divine ethics. There is the problem. We are all living, and we are living up by our own interests, by our own inner tendencies. We don't know whether it is matching with the world, and we don't know whether we are changing the course of world in right direction or not. So for that, we need observation. Everyone should observe their own inner condition every day. By that, they will find out what are the problems with themselves. Then only they can try to correct. Then only they can correct. If not, nobody is going to correct our system. We have to correct our system. Likewise, I am promoting meditation as a better tool for transformation, because with meditation, we'll try to observe ourselves daily. By that, we'll find out what are the faults within us first. Instead of pointing others, instead of pointing with fighting with others, first we'll try to realize what are the problems with us. Then we'll try to conclude. Then we'll try to change. If you maintain a diary, your diary is going to show you are a transformed person after 10 years. How much percentage transformation, doesn't matter. Even 0.5% transformation may be sufficient for the entire time of course, lifetime course. Instead of living with same attitude and same struggle, changing in our attitude will bring a better life course. That's why I am promoting meditation, the two heartfulness meditation. For past 18 years, I am practicing this, and it is so wonderful and so excellent. I face a lot of struggles in patient lives, first of all. So many issues, so many monetary issues, so many issues I face daily in our routine life, in my routine life. But whenever I feel tired, whenever I feel not comfortable, I immediately start meditation, and that inner divine yogic transmission will help me to clear my problems, will clear my inner confusion, and it will let me to have a better understanding, better decision making, everything that will be happening with this meditation. So that's how my meditation helped me to stand with my own personality all these years. That's why I promote meditation. So meditation is a better tool of education. So this is a lifetime course, and practice makes man perfect. Not a single day practice or 10 days practice or 1 month practice or 1 year practice cannot keep us perfect. There is a continuous practice of for lifetime. So this is what about heartfulness meditation. This heartfulness meditation is now open for the total world. And anytime, anywhere, you can sit in meditation with thinking that divine light present in my heart. You will get connected. If you need assistance, There are so many YouTube channels are there. Heartfulness, number one, and Heartsapp, HEARTSAPP, Heartsapp. That if you install in your mobiles, there are so many stress detox, relaxation, meditation. So many sessions are there in that Heartsapp. With them, you can relax, you can guide yourself. And in internet also, so many classes are available, master classes of heartfulness meditation. All these things are available for everyone in this world. So you can utilize their services for totally free. Tomorrow there will be a cleaning session. That means I will teach you how to clean ourselves with the help of yogic transmission. So that session will be very peaceful and very beautiful. And youth need it, definitely youth need it, because nowadays people are becoming so emotional. They don't have control over their emotions. This cleaning will help to control their emotions and balancing themselves. So it will be also same session, like 20 minutes tomorrow. It will be, sitting will be 20 minutes and 10 minutes before explanation, 10 minutes after.
And thank you so much, Dr. Hariprasad sir.
Welcome.